Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to overwinter plants, bring them inside safely, and reduce the chances of bringing pests inside your grow room. So with every season, there are always plants that you want to save, and taking the plants from outside inside is a big risk because it could come along with pests like aphids and fungus gnats and all these other pests that would just cause problem inside the grow tent. So today I'm going to show you a method that you can use to try to reduce those problems and potentially prevent them. It's not going to be 100%, but it's going to be more than likely that you will not have pests if you follow these same procedures. So I have a plant right here, and I really don't want to lose it because it took a long time to get to this size, and then I didn't get the fruits until now, and then it's already too late. So these are nice fruits, and I want to keep this plant for the next season because next year it's going to produce a lot more and a lot faster because it's already an old plant. So I'm gonna pull this out of my raised bed, put it into a container, and take it inside. So we don't want to bring any pests along with that. So the first thing we're going to do is we need to cut off all of the branches. And if there are any leaves that are remain, we're gonna have to pull those off as well. So basically we're just going to take the bare plant inside. And also we're going to reduce the root ball of the plant. And that way we can put it inside a smaller container so that we can have more space for other plants. Okay, so the first step you're gonna have to do, and this is usually the toughest part for everybody, and that is to strip the entire plant down, cut it all back. If there are fruits on there, get rid of it. And this is why it's tough, because you don't want to waste all those fruits. But believe me, it's gonna be worth it if you do this, and those fruits will grow back the next season. So just go ahead and if you can use the fruit, use them, but if you can't, just toss them. So here I have these fruits here. You see? What a waste, isn't it? So because these are such beautiful fruits. So here we go. Let's go ahead and cut it out. Okay, so before we trim the entire plant down, if you want to propagate from branches, you can actually do that as well. So pick a nice big branch and put it in water, and I will show you what I've done inside. That way, if you want to do that also, you can do the exact same. So don't just toss these branches away, because they could be used to propagate new branches and new plants for the next season as well. Okay, so there's really not much left of the plant, so now we're gonna have to dig it out. Okay, we dug the plant out, and as you can see, there's really not much of the plant left. You can get rid of some of the roots, because when we're overwintering, we don't need all of the roots, just enough for the plant to survive. And also, you see those leaves that are left? We're gonna get rid of those right now. We don't want any leaves, because leaves could carry pests along with them, and the pest could be hiding underneath and you will not see it. Okay, cut your plant to all around the same length, like that. And these roots right here, you can get rid of some. You don't need all that, depending on how large your container is. If it's small, get rid of more. If there's the container is large, you can save them. So because my container is pretty small, I'm gonna get rid of these here. Okay, and now we're gonna have to wash off the entire plant. Okay, this is what we have, just a bare root plant. So now let's go ahead and pot it up, and I will show you what to do next. Okay, I cleaned off the plant and we are ready to pot this up. You see, it's just a bare plant. So next is one of the most important steps, and that is to select a soil that potentially does not have fungus gnats in it. So when you go buy soil at your home garden center, or you know, those big box stores or whatever, make sure you select the type of soil that is enclosed, like there's no holes for the fungus nests to get in. Those other bags where they sit outside, those could potentially have holes somewhere, and then fungus gnats could get into it when they're sitting at the stores. So avoid those. These are great here. I've used them for a while, and most of the time I've never had issues with fungus gnats unless I bring other plants from the outside inside the tent, and then I could introduce the gnats to my tent. But these have been one of the type of soil that I find that does not have any. So it's been working for a while for me. So that's what I'm using. So make sure to use the right type of soil is very, very important, because if you choose ones with gnats in it, it's gonna get so annoying inside your tent and it's gonna spread real fast. Okay, so that's one of the way to prevent it from happening. And I'm going to use this milk jug here because these are containers that I use over and over and over again. That way, and I made a handle. I basically just cut off the top and then leave a handle here. And so what we're gonna do, you see how some plants might be too big? That way you have to get rid of some of the roots and try to fit it in there. This is just a temporary home, so it doesn't matter that it's small, because we don't want the plant to grow too much anyway. So you can get rid of more roots if you want to, and that would work as well. So now we'll just add . Notice I don't have any holes at the bottom because I want to keep my tent nice and clean. So you're gonna have to also monitor how much water you have, and usually it's by the weight. Just kind of like weight it and know how heavy it is when it's wet or how light it is, and then you can just give it a little bit of water. So over the winter you don't have to give it too much water, just enough for the plant to stay alive. You don't want it to grow anyway. And if it does grow too much, just trim it. I do like this so that the soil can go to the bottom. Okay. So now we're gonna give it some water, and you're not gonna water it for a while. So you kind of judge it by how heavy it is. Okay, another way to overwinter your plants when you don't have space inside your house or garage is to overwinter them outside. So this method does not always work because it does depend on certain conditions. So when I live in Texas, so our temperature does get down to freezing, but it doesn't stay that way for a long time. So if you live further north, this method would not work. So if you are in zone 8A or 8B or whatever, this method will work because I've done it before, and it's not always going to be 100%, so you're going to have to do a few, and then a few plants will survive. So if you want to see results, go back to my 2015 videos where I showed this, and I will link it to you guys so you can see it. Okay, so what we're going to use is these trash bags here, and these are the clear trash bags. So basically what we're trying to do is create a dome for these plants, and then we're gonna put it against the wall of the house or somewhere close by. That way it can use the heat of the house to keep itself warm in case there is a freeze for a day or two. So we're gonna have to also trim it back, and then we're also gonna have to fill up the soil. That way it keeps the roots nice and warm. I threw cucumbers in there. Those are just for composting. But that's what we're gonna do. So let's go ahead and cut down the plant. And we're gonna have to cut it down pretty far. And then we're gonna cover the bag over and create a greenhouse within this container. Okay, look how much of the plant is left. So the next thing we're going to do is take our clear bag. And then we're going to wrap it like that. Now be careful not to create a hole in the bag, because if you create holes, the cool air can get through, and that could potentially damage the plants. So make sure when you cut it across like this. That way it doesn't have any sharp edges. And then you're gonna put it against the wall closer to the house, where it has a sort of like a sunny side that can keep it warm. So it has a microclimate. Okay, look what we cut down, and I picked some of the remaining pods. These look just like the peach pumpkin. So the late season lemon starbursts look just like its cousin or sibling, the peach pumpkin. But anyway, here are the plants. So that's where it's gonna sit, right against the wall. And as you can see, there is a dome above it. And that should keep the plant nice and warm throughout the winter. And make sure you water the plant before you do this. That way you're not gonna have to water for a while. So give it a good, nice, thorough watering. And then you're not gonna do it for a long time. And occasionally just come out and check on it. If it requires some kind of water, you can tell the soil is dry. Give it a little bit. It doesn't take too much because there's no leaves. And it's not gonna lose a lot of moisture this way. So we'll check back in the spring, and possibly these will live, maybe not, but it's worth a shot. I mean, they're gonna die anyway, so why not try it? Okay, I've brought the plant inside, and here it is. And then I have some other ones over there. You see, this one's been a few days, probably a week already, and there's new growth already. And I have some of that over there. You see, these are same thing. I did the exact same thing, and they're already growing back. So with proper lighting and proper temperature, these things grow back very fast. So, and then here, you see these here? These are the branches that you can attempt to propagate. All you have to do is just cut a branch and then put it in water. Just cut a few, because not all of them are gonna work. But you're gonna get, like, you know, a pretty good chance that one of the few branches will propagate it and root, and then you can grow that into a new plant for the next season. So I do this every year. So don't throw your plants out when you cut it down. Take some branches, take as many as you can, put it into multiple containers like this. Just water, that's all you need, nothing else. And just let it sit there under grow light, and then it will eventually root. And then you have many plants to grow for the next season. So while I'm here, I'm going to answer a few more questions that people are usually interested in. And one of the questions is, what is the proper lighting that you should provide your plants in order for them to survive throughout the winter? So you don't need a grow light like this, but if you do have it, then it will assist with the growth, and they will grow very fast with proper lighting. But you just need, you know, like three to four hours of really good light, and after that you just give them a little bit of light, and that's fine, because you want them to overwinter, which means you give them little water, little light, and keep the temperature around 55 degrees Fahrenheit, because at that temperature they don't grow very much, and when they don't grow very much, they don't drink very much. So that is actually a win-win, because you want to overwinter and not allow them to grow. Because I have a grow tent and my light is pretty heavy duty, these guys are gonna grow like crazy. So what I'm gonna have to do is trim, because as they grow, they're gonna start to take over the spaces. So I'm gonna have to trim them. So usually I just keep them outside in the garage, not in the grow tent, but just in the garage. And then I would open the garage door when the temperature is warm. If it's like in the freezing zone, don't open the garage door. But if it's in like 50s to 55 degrees Fahrenheit, you can open it Even in the 40s, like in the mid 40s, you can open the garage because inside the garage, the temperature is still warmer than outside. So they will stay alive. They won't grow very much. So you don't need to give them like extremely good light, like if you're trying to grow them inside. You can put them by a bright window and that would work as well. The cooler the temperature, the slower they will grow. And that is actually good. So if you give them warm temperature, they're gonna grow much faster and then you're gonna have to trim very often. So those are one of the key questions that people always ask. And I think another one that I already mentioned is, can you trim? Yes, you can absolutely trim. So at this size here, you really don't wanna trim because they're too small, but as they grow, they're gonna span out like this. Then you can trim. You can trim as much as you want, as long as you can you know, give them some nodes right there to grow, they should be fine. And another question is, how much can you cut up the plant in order to keep them over winter? And you can cut as much as you like. So here, you see I leave a pretty good amount because I plan to cut more and I cut more. And I plan to maybe propagate these. So that's why I leave them like that. You see here? So they're going to grow and they're gonna have shoots like that. So I plan to cut those and then propagate them, so that's why I leave them that big. But you can actually cut all the way down to, you know, like around 2 inches left, and they will still grow out of the ground with the proper condition, of course. If your temperature in the soil is warm, they will be fine because they have a really good root system down there. So they will grow back all the way down to here. So if there's a node, you see this section like this? Those are a node. If you see a node down here, and if you cut right here, that the little piece right here will grow. So you can see here, that one was cut pretty low. You see that? And it grows all the way down there. So if I cut all of these top area and just leave this much left, the plant will grow from down here out. So they're very, very hardy plants. So you can cut, as I mentioned, as low as like 2 inches left and they will still be fine. So here, again, the soil you use is very important. You can see my grow room has no fungus gnats right now because I'm very, very careful. Anytime I bring the plant from outside, I strip the soil completely and I will only use the new soil. Don't reuse the soil from outside. It's a risk. So just get new soil. The ones that potentially don't have any fungus gnats, like the one I show you, the Pro Mix, that's a good one. It's really worth it to use new soil. So get rid of all of the old soil before you bring it inside. And what is the light hours that I use for my plants? That's another question. So that really depends. Right here, I'm growing plants as well as overwintering plants. So I let the light runs for 10 hours a day because as you can see, I'm also doing hydroponic and I'm testing some other stuff over there. So that's why. And here's some other hydroponic, but you don't have to run the lights 10 hours a day. You can run it like 3 to 4 hours a day if you only plan to overwinter. So also, how cold can the room be for the plants to be alive? As I mentioned, in the 50s is ideal. 50 degrees Fahrenheit is ideal because they're not gonna grow much and they're not gonna die. But in the 40s, like the mid 40s, then they're gonna start to suffer. So keep it in the 50s for the best results. Because sometimes in the 40s, in the soil is still warmer, so the plant will still be alive. But if it's any lower than that, it's going to die for an extended period. So it's always best to keep it at 50 degrees Fahrenheit and higher. Okay, so that is all I'm gonna cover for this video, and I hope that will help you with your overwintering. I've done this every year for the past few years, and it's been working every season. I'm going to do more overwintering, and maybe I will answer some more questions if you guys are interested in. So make sure to leave down in the comments some of the questions that you want me to answer, and then I will add it to the future videos. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.